Just a disclaimer before this video starts that you can actually run as many copies of whatever account you want. You don't have to listen to what I say. You can run as many copies what you feel that's comfortable for your type of deck that you're making. You don't have to listen to anyone's advice. You can just listen to your own. Or if you think it's good enough for you, run as many copies as you want. I'm not saying no to anything. This is just a disclaimer to notify everyone that's watching this video that you can run as many copies as you want. Don't have to listen to what I say. Okay? Okay, let's begin. So in this video, I will be doing an argument-based analysis of what this person and I have been discussing for quite a while now. And yeah, it gets a bit interesting, I guess you could say, in terms of arguments or whether you run certain ratios of a certain card that you can run 3 of it or 2 of it or whatever with it. Just letting you know that you can run as many copies as you want. I'm not saying no to anything, but in terms of card economy and also resource ability management, if you think that using more cards in your hand is saving resources, or you think that it's a better play for turn one, it depends on how you look at things. But I will get into it and let's explain it as I go and break down the arguments of both parties, of me and this other person. So this person, person called Josh, I think. So he starts the argument saying, "I feel like Free Spirit Master is needed. If you don't have Squire, Spirit Master will allow for single plays when paired either juniors or solitaire." Now I reply with, "Yes, if you have no copies of Squire, you can run 3 copies of Spirit Master." That's my personal opinion if making a budget-based deck. Now, this is what I'm referring to, a budget-based deck. Personally, I agree with him. If you want to run 3 Spirit Master, go ahead. I'm not saying no to that. But firstly, for me, if I was making a budget version, you can run 3 copies. But if you want to play 3 in a deck, go ahead. I'm not saying no to that. I personally agree with him. If he wants to play 3, play 3. Spirit Master will allow for single plays when paired with each other. Yeah, that's right. That's pretty simple. So next one, he replies, "You can't really rely on drawing Squire every single game, but Spirit Master lets you make plays if you don't draw the Squire." I'm like, yeah, I'm aware of this one, the Squire plays. So yeah, so what is your point here exactly? So yeah, I know you don't have to rely on, you can't rely on Squire every single game, but running 3 of it is definitely a good way to get into your head quicker now, isn't it? Then I respond with, "Spirit Master requires more cards to extend plays. He's not good by himself," which is actually true, because if you have him in your starting hand, you need another monster in your hand or in your graveyard to actually use, since Spirit Master is not that good turn 1 unless you have additional plays. Yes, it's good if you have a tuner and or a solitaire in your hand. If you have Spirit Master, Spirit Master summons out solitaire from your hand, or Nala, tuner, and then you Synchro summon into your other monsters. But it depends, because not all the time you're not gonna use Spirit Master, and Spirit Master is kind of a tech-based card. It's not really a main deck card, in a way, if you get my drift, because Spirit Master it's good if you want to make a turn 1 synchro using what you have in your hand, like you have nothing else to use. But if you have a Spirit Master and a Squire, of course you're going to go for the Squire. But if you're playing Spirit Master, then yeah, definitely play it. But I'm not saying no to any of his arguments. I'm very open about what he's saying, but then we start discussing into more of a heat. So he says, "Spirit plus level 2 tuner equals synchro." Yes, that's true. "Spirit plus level 3 equals synchro." Yes, that's true. "Spirit plus solitaire equals synchro." Yes, that's true. And then he says, "Obviously, Spirit needs one other card to make a play, but don't forget that you can special for them from grave. Yes, that's true, but the graveyard is only for turn 3 or, yeah, turn 3 onwards. It's not that good turn 2 or turn 1, because you don't want to waste resources in your hand, because depending on what's good in your hand, you can either lose resources or you can only survive what you have currently in your hand. This is card economy in hand management 101. Basically, if you're using, so let's say, yeah, so in Duel Links, you start with 4 cards in your hand. Spirit Master plus another monster, let's say whatever he says, is turn 1. So you're using 2 cards from your hand, plus you have 2 extra card cards in your hand, so you have 4 cards total. You have 2 left in your hand. You use two resources in your hand, Spirit Master plus another monster, in order to make a Synchro. So you just waste 2 resources and you have 2 resources left. Either those are spell and trap cards, or those are monsters that you can use probably for next turn. If it's another Spirit Master, that's fine. But if that's the only thing you can do turn 1, then that's all good, because that's the only thing you can do. I'm not saying no to anything. If you can make that type of play, go ahead. I'm not saying no, but yeah. I'm just saying that using two resources rather than 1 resource. That's all I'm just saying. Nothing. I'm not trying to be mean or anything. I'm just saying it's just using 2 resources rather than 1 resource. And then he specifies there are plenty of cards in good decks that aren't good by themselves. That's kind of a, excuse me, argument. He's a 1 card synchro just like Squire. As long as you have 1 of 3 cards in grave or in hand, you can't rely on drawing Squire every opening hand though. Yeah, I agree though. I agree on the last argument where you can't rely on drawing Squire every single game. That's true. But the one thing I do not agree with is that he says it's a 1 card synchro just like Squire, as long as you have 1 of 3 cards in grave. This is the part I do not agree with, and this is where it gets the argument gets very heated. And first of all, what do you refer to as a 1 card synchro in Duel Links or anything in Yu-Gi-Oh in general? 1 card synchro in this term is 1 specific card, 1 card only. 1 card means no other card in your hand to use for a single summon or specification of what you're trying to do. Since Spirit Master needs something else to do something, that's not considered a 1 card synchro. That's considered a 2 card for 1 card synchro. And you're just going probably minus 1. For example, 1 card synchro is you're going minus 0. That's how things are usually treated as 1 card in terms of making plays. But since you can't do it with by himself, that's what you mean by 1 card. 1 card, unless it's 1 plus 1 equals 2, which that means you need 2 cards. He specifies it himself. Spirit plus level 2 tutor plus synchro equals synchro. Spirit plus level 3 equals synchro. That's basically 1 card plus 1 card equals synchro. So that's 1 plus 1 equals 2. And he said 1 card synchro, which is 1 card by himself. So yeah, yeah, most stuff I do agree with what he's saying, but he's just rambling on about it being a 1 card synchro, but it's not. So this is where I get into the argument of saying things. So 1 card synchro means nothing else in hand or in grave for its effect. Spirit Master requires at least 1 other Shiranui monster. This down so you guys can see. Oops, too far down. There we go. So let me just repeat it again. So 1 card synchro means nothing else in hand or grave. For its effect, Spirit Master requires at least 1 other Shiranui monster from either hand or grave. The obvious, the one in hand in grave is obviously turn 3 onwards, unless you have an additional card in hand that dumps it from the deck to graveyard, turn 1. And that's if you can't use anything else from your hand, while Squire is a 1 card synchro, since it doesn't have to be from hand and use a Shiranui Spectral Sword monster from your deck instead. So what I'm, and also yes, you know that you can't always rely on drawing Squire every single hand, that's what I agree with. What I'm trying to say is, one card synchro means nothing else that you use for resources. So one card means one card by himself, nothing else. As Spirit Master requires at least one other Spirit Master, which I did explain from this argument, which I've been explaining before. And yeah, he obviously does not get it. So at any, oh yeah, and I reply with also yes. And can't always rely on it from your hand. So let me just move this up so you guys can see more easily. So the next one we go into is this argument. So I would like to make the argument that Spirit is a one card synchro. Yes, you need something in the grave or on hand, but guess what? You get four cards at the start of the game, not one. So now he's talking about card, starting cards in hand, turn one. Okay, so starting cards in hand, yeah, you get four cards in hand, not one. That's true, but we are not discussing about starting cards in hand, but we are, but yet we aren't. What we were referring to before was what defines a one card synchro. He's defining that two cards equals a one card synchro. That's true, but it's a, well, that's true in a way of referring to one, two cards making one card synchro. But a one card, it's confusing in a way, but basically you need two cards to make one synchro monster. That's what we're trying to, that's what I'm trying to discuss. The odds of you not, of you having one of the correct cards to pair with Spirit is very high. Yes, but also no. Also no, if you watched my video for the second Shirinori video, I show that sometimes you don't always draw into Spirit Master or Squire, but that depends on how you do plays, because not, you can't really get OTK'd unless you're feeling black wings of that, and you kind of can predict how you can survive turn 1 or turn 2. So in a way you don't really have to go synchro turn 1 unless you're smart, but it, or know how to manage your resources. Like in the video, I managed my resource perfectly. I knew I wouldn't be OTK'd because I was versing, I knew I was versing a deck that wasn't reliant on OTKing. So I took the risk, and I set some, I set a tuner monster, the spiritual sword, which I'll show later on. Sorry, I'm still a bit sick. Okay, the odds of you making, the odds of you having one of the correct cards to pair with Spirit are very high. Spirit are very high. Now that's actually something that I would discuss about. Yes, the odds of having cards that you can use for a synchro turn one is very high, but it depends on how you construct your deck. Also, Spirit gives you a synchro pair for turn two. That is true. Turn your turn two rather than your opponent's turn two. If your opponent's going second, but yeah, your turn two. Since the synchro materials are in the graveyard, since, yeah, that's true, you can use stuff for turn 2, your turn 2, for Spirit Master later on, allowing you to make a synchro with only one card. Yes, that's true, but that's later on in the duel. We're talking about turn 1, not turn 3 or turn 4 onwards. And yes, I do agree with what he's trying to say, but what are you trying to say for argument stuff for later on? We're talking about turn 1 rather than turn 3 or 4. If you're referring to one card by himself, then yes, it's a one card synchro for turn 3 or 4 onwards, so you can use resources from your graveyard later on. You can reuse your resources from your graveyard, but we're talking about turn 1. Personally, I do agree with him, turn 3 and onwards, that it is a one card synchro to using previous resources in the grave, but this is what we're trying to discuss. Is it one card synchro turn one or turn two? And it is not. Also, Spirit gives you a synchro play for turn two, since the synchro materials are in the grave, allowing you to make a synchro also with only using one card. Your subpar arguments give me reassurance that free Spirit is the way to go. No, 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 no. I never said you should run free Spirit. I said if you can run free Spirit, go ahead. Or if you're making budget type of deck, run free spirit. That's what I would suggest. As I'm saying, suggest you don't have to run free spirit if you spirit master if you don't want to. I never said you did have to. You're over here giving me the technical definition of a one card synchro as your argument, like you've got it from Webster's dictionary. Technically, it's common knowledge for Yu-Gi-Oh players. But yeah, I don't know what he's referring to from me getting stuff from Webster's dictionary. But this is where things get heated even more. I mean, look at your first three clips of video, dude. If you have a spirited pair, let me just scroll this down a bit. To pair with the Soltail Tuners, you could have made an actual play instead of set, pass, and hope they don't have a back row removal. First of all, I knew what I was doing for those type of plays, which I will explain later on as I explain my clips. In a way, or explain my replays. Free spirit is the way to go. You said it yourself, you can't count on drawing Swire every game, and set pass isn't going to cut against higher competition. That is very true. If you're versing a very OGK based deck, you can't rely on setting cards turn 1 or turn 2 or whatever. Just rely on what you got for what you do have. But if you know what you're versing, or you can predict what you're versing, then yeah, you can automatically know what you're going to verse and rely on your back row. But if you verse something like Hey Trunade stuff, well, that's bad luck, because your opponent's going to return every single back row to your hand, and you're probably going to get OTK'd anyway. Or if you just make a synchro turn 1, and they have, like, say, you're versing Ritual Beast, and they just bounce something to your hand without destroying it, then yeah, that's pretty bad as well. So either way, you're kind of screwed no matter what. So now I make the argument. Okay, so let me get straight. You rather use more resources from your hand turn 1 with Spirit Master, which you think is a one card synchro. What I'm referring to is turn 1. This, as you can see, I'm referring to the discussion as a turn 1 play, not turn 3 or turn onwards. Turn whatever onwards. What you think is a one card synchro. Spirit plus a monster in your hand is a one card synchro. It's more like Spirit plus Shirinuri equals synchro. So it's Shirinuri. Spirit plus another one equals synchro. That's two cards to make one card. Whilst Squire in the hand, starting hand of four, uses less resources from the hand and summons a sword from deck rather than the hand. How much did I use from my hand and left over to use from the starting turn 1 to 2, 3 onwards? That depends on what you think of your definition of using resources. You should be winning the duel with that. Should be winning the duel if you need that. If you need that third spirit master, anyways. And I've already gone into my third, and I don't need it if I actually. This is the part where I kind of stumble things. It was in the middle of the night when I was discussing this. So you don't need the third spirit master if you're winning. Basically, I've used the first Mirror Master, and you're kind of wasting resources as it is. I mean, no. Spirit Master is good late game, but not good early game. That's what I'm trying to say. And basically, you would use it with Gold Sark and stuff just to pop stuff. But you can use Gold Sark in different ways to manipulate your banisher area. So you can banish a Solitaire to actually bring back resources, which I do in the video, I think. But yeah. How much do I use from here? Should be window if you if I go into third. I don't need it if I plan ahead with resource management, which is true. If you plan ahead using resource management, for how you manage your resources in the early game, then you don't really need the third Spirit Master. Unless you're abusing it for the hell of it, then go ahead, use it as many ones as you want. You don't have to run three if you don't want to. But I like to run two. People can run free, go, then that's their opinion. They can run free if they want. The level 2 tuner is very abusable, and Gold Sarcophagus, that was a mistype for me, can use other means of banish manipulation rather than waste it on Spirit Master, because it pops face up cards, and that doesn't happen all the time. If you're making a budget deck or want to use Spirit Master, go ahead, and I'm not complaining. As I'm saying, I'm not complaining. If you want to run free of it, go ahead. But you can But can you do math, which is what I'm trying to say? 4 minus 2 equals 1. It's no links hand math. I'm referring to the starting hand. If you can get by the number 4, everyone knows what the number 4 is in Duel Links. Sort of. It means you start with 4 cards in your starting hand, unless you're going second, which you start with 5. This is what I'm referring to turn 1 plays. Turn 3 onwards, yes, I agree. You can use, if you have another Spirit Master hand, that you can reuse resources from your graveyard as well. So, in a way, it makes 1 card plays later on. But this is what I'm trying to refer to as turn 1 plays, not turn 3 plays. If it's turn 3 plays, I agree with you 100%. 100%. But this is what we're referring to as turn 1. Please get that in your mind. I'm not trying to make things look bad for you. I'm just trying to disclose this argument in a video so that you can understand what I'm trying to say verbally. That I've been trying to discuss for the past few arguments already that we're relying on turn 1 plays, not turn 3 plays or turn 2 plays. You could have asked, are you referring to turn 1 plays, or turn 3 plays, or turn 2 plays? As a redefining question, then yeah, I can readjust my question, as I'm a nice person. I'm not going to say, no, this is turn 3 onwards. I'm not going to do that. I'd rather be a person that is open about what we're discussing about. But yeah. Alright, so now he goes on to, why in the world are you still trying to compare spirit to Squire, when we've agreed that you can't always rely on drawing the Squire? That's true. I'm not trying to compare it to Spirit or Squire. I'm just saying Squire is a turn 1 card that is really good, but is also good later on, depending on how you do it. It's kind of the opposite of Spirit Master, but yeah, that's why I prefer drawing it more as I run as a 3 off rather than a 2 off. When we agreed you can't rely on drawing Squire. If you don't draw the Squire, your next best combo is to use Spirit to make a combo play. That's true. That's the next best play to make a Synchro play. That I obviously agree on. Obviously, Squire is better than Spirit, but unfortunately, we can only use 3 of that card. No crap. There are 2 main ways to make a Synchro on turn 1. With Squire and with Spirit. Since we won't draw Squire every single game, we need Spirit to still be able to synchro into the same monster. Hang on, this is a part where I maybe didn't read properly. And since we don't win draw Squire every game, okay, I do agree on that. We need Spirit to be a Spirit Master. Sorry, that's right. I was trying to read to be able to synchro into the same monsters that you were synchro with Squire. Yeah, that's true. That's good if you're doing it turn 3 onwards. But remember, we're trying to discuss things with turn 1 plays. If you're saying Spirit Master is a 1 card synchro overall for turn 1 onwards, like the whole title, yes and no. It's not good in the beginning part, but it's also good in the later half. That's what I'm trying to discuss. Spirit also allows for plays when paired in the graveyard with the level 2 tuner. You can banish both from the grave with the level 2 tuner's effect. Yes, I do agree on that. Which this is how you can use for resource management in the graveyard using the level 2 tuner. I do agree on that. This is what I discussed about before. I'm pretty sure I did. I discussed it before. Abusable. Level 2 tuners are very abusable and gold soft. Yada yada. That's what I agreed on. Like right here. Both current level 2 effects, synchro into level 6 and destroy face up. Card on the field. On top of that, the main way to synchro into the boss monster level 10, you need Squire plus a level 4 monster in your head for augmentation. That is true. Guess what? Spirit is a level 4. Yeah? So having 3 spirits increase your odds of having level 4 in the combo. Well, you're not gonna draw a spirit not in time. If you can also draw another Salt as well, not just a Squire. I mean, if you open up Squire plus another monster. Then yeah, and I just realized I'm gonna have to move this back a bit. There we go. I mean, you're not always gonna have all three monsters. I'm like, yeah, if you run more copies of monsters, you can draw more easily. But if you construct your deck the way it is, and now you manage it, then you don't really care about it, to be honest. Okay, so need level 10 for check. Guess what? Spirit is a level 4, so having 3 spirits increases your odds of having level 4 for the combo. Personally, you can also use level 3 as well if you draw into that. So there are plenty of different ways you can actually start off with that with level augmentation. You can start with level 4 or level 3, and if you open up a level 2 or using Squire for level 2 plays from the deck, then yeah, there's plenty of ways, different ways to it. You can actually synchro summon into level 10 turn 1. So many different ways. You don't have to just rely on level 4 in your head, personally. For instance, increase your odds of having level 4 odds of having that level 4 for the combo. And gives you a synchro play for the following turn. What happens if you draw both your spirits and now you can't use Cold Suck to pop a face up? Well, that sucks, because you probably just dead drew. I mean, what happens if you draw all three of your Spirit Masters and a Gold Suck? You're kind of screwed either way. So I don't get the argument of what you're trying to say. Yeah, then you drew bad cards, bad luck. But that rarely happens, since I'm running two copies of Spirit Master. That means I have less chance of drawing the second one. But if I do draw a second one, well, that's bad luck. Looks like you're just making random math when you say 4 plus 2 equals 1. I'm saying stuff for starting hand argument. I'm not trying to say random math. I'm trying to say you start with 4 cards in your hand, using 2 cards to make, using Spirit Master and another Spirit Master to make a 1 card synchro. That's what I'm referring to, if you can get that for your fixed skull. Spirit might not be a turn 1. Oh my god, this guy trying to explain stuff and not mess. Might not be a good play for turn 1, that is true. 1 card synchro, no way, you think he's trying to refer to it as a one, turn 1, 1 card synchro. Okay, then why did you put a comma at the end of the turn 1? Spirit might not be a turn 1, 1 card synchro. Why did you put a commas at the end of each of your... So he put commas right here and right here. Man, this guy needs to fix up his grammar. But it is, well, I'm not complaining about my grammar, even though I do misplay and mistake my grammar sometimes. That's on me. But it is a turn 2, 1 card synchro, since you will have a Shinryu in your graveyard already. Yeah, that's true. It's good for later games, not just the beginning game. I like to hear argument from you about how you shouldn't use free spirit, and that doesn't involve the technical definition of one card synchro or a comparison between Squire, which anyone with a brain knows is a better card. Well, that's true. Squire is a better card turn 1, and any other cards in general for turn 3 or whatever, depending if you don't draw Squire early enough. And spirit, if I were you, I would take out a second level 2, I would take out the second level 2 tuner or one of the floodgates to make a run, to make room for a first spirit. Did I run 3 or did I run 1? I can't remember. I think I ran 2 of the level 3s and one of the level 2s. Oh no, I'll go into it for a breakdown later on. That's it, the word breakdown. I was trying to go for a breakdown. Alright, then I reply, I never said you shouldn't run 3 spirit. I never said you shouldn't use 3 spirit masters. But sure, I'll make a video on everything we discussed so far, which I have. Alright, now let's go into a breakdown of the content. So, in the video, I ran 3 of the level 3s. And let's just go into the deck profile. Sorry for it a bit blurry. Let's try and find a good one. So yeah, I ran 3 of the 2 of level 3s, and as you can see, I ran 2 level 3s and one of the level 2. I don't know where he got the other level 2 from. Maybe it was from the other video. But as you can see here, I run 2 Spirit Masters, 3 Squire, because I want to draw Squire quicker, and it's a better card turn 1 play later on. But it depends on how you view things. And yeah. Alright, so let's go into this video, shall we? So, starting hand is Junior Solitaire. So turn 1 is Alexis's play. That person sets a card. Now, I knew that this person wasn't going to OTK me because they only set one card. So, with this hand, it's actually pretty bad in terms of foul stuff. I usually show ways to get show videos or clips that is actually bad for you, but how you can actually get around it in a way. I'm not trying to make combo wombo boards turn 1. I'm showing different ways to actually how to play the deck. If you don't open the best cards like Squire or a Squire or a Spirit Master. I mean, you can just watch other YouTubers that actually do that. For me, I like to do different ways of making videos that other people don't. So I just set all my cards, all my back rows face down, and then I just pass because I know I set. As you can see here, too far back. So I drew into a floodgate and my turn 1 hand, I drew a World Legacy Clash and a floodgate. I knew I wasn't going to get OTK'd because I had the floodgate trap in my hand, so I was safe to set everything. You don't always have to set everything, and plus, with this starting hand, I have a level 2, was a level 3, no, that's a level 3, so if I survive the next turn, which I obviously do, I can go into level 7 later on, which is much, much better than the level 10 at this point. So then he tries to summon a monster, and I floodgate him because, yeah, I don't want that, this Gravekeeper monster, I can't remember the name, to pop any of my cards, so I try to match resources as much as I can. So he adds that monster, that Gravekeeper monster. So I go a level Og, I flip the Shiranui, and I make it level 7, and I Synchro for the level 10. I mean, I can make a level 4, or level 10 or level 7, but either way, it's gonna work. So then I make Sansaka, and then I just try and beat for damage, and that's another way of doing stuff. So yeah, I did use the skill later on, but I didn't really need it in the beginning. So then the duel escalates, and the World Legacy Clash comes in hand later on. So here's where Spirit Master is very, very handy if you're going turn 3 onwards. I drew it later on, but that's fine. It's a good card late game, but not good during the early game, so I didn't mind that. You don't really care about that because, well, reasons. So then I make another Shinui Synchro Monster, the Samurai Saga, and yeah, I try to poke for stuff, and then he quits when I floodgate him again. Oops. So let's go into another replay. So this is my starting hand. We got World Legacy Clash, Cosmic Cyclone, and a Floodgate. This is actually a really, really good hand turn 1, which I am going turn 1. So usually we would set everything and set Shiranui Monster and pass. That's actually a really broken hand if you're not getting OTK'd. But if you are getting OTK'd and you get Hatrinated, then, well, GG. But that's the price you pay. So then I go Solitaire, running the... Oh, yes, that's right, making level 2. That's right. So what I did was... So I'm going to break down this play. So I went Shiranui Solitaire, tributed it off for the level 2. The reason why the level 2 is so, so good is that if it gets destroyed by battle, hopefully not banished. If it gets banished, well, that's bad luck for me. So if he destroys it by battle, I can use it next turn for a Synchro play, and I can reuse it again. So, yeah. It's really good. So this person goes subversing Black Wings. So This is very, very, very dangerous, but since I know how to counter black wings, I can easily counter with my back row. So since I drew Cosmic Cyclone, that's a really, really good card against the black wings, since they need black whirlwind in order to extend their plays. So as you can see in this replay, once I get rid of the black whirlwind, he's forced to just use all of his resources from his hand, which in black wings you don't want to in a way, but you can, because it allows you to make plays in hand, I guess. I'm not really good at discussing these type of arguments, sorry. But he's forced to use resources in his hand, and he's down to like two cards in his hand rather than, actually no, he started with four, then he started with five. Yeah, anyway, so he brings back the black wing and just destroys it. As I predicted, I'm out of resources on my field, but I have a World Exit Clash, but now I have the Spectral Sword in my grave, which it was set there last turn, turn two, by him attacking into it. People will just attack into stuff no matter what in Duel Links, so yeah. Unless you're versing a smart player, they will not attack, because they know that I have a level 2. But if I draw a level 4, which I did not, just draw it now, the risk of them, of me having a monster in my hand is pretty high. But he thought I had a level 4 in my hand, so he got rid of it immediately. But either way, I was going to make it one card synchro no matter what. But if he just left on the field, then yeah, I would have literally had to pass turn. So I'm going to use Spectral Sword's effect right now and make a level 6 play. And I'm going to make I'm going to summon level 3 and use this effect to bring back two more monsters and then abuse it again. And then we make a level 8, which is really, really nice. So because its effect becomes live, and then I just OTK'd him. So yeah, planning ahead is very, very helpful in Duel Links. And now I'm going to get mad. Okay, so this is another Shuzu player, so now we open up with Squire. Squire is really, really good. So then I go into the basic plays for Synchro Shenanigans. Oops, pressed the wrong button. So now I make a level 6, and yeah, pass turn by setting all my back row. This is another tech card that people play, Herald of the Abyss, or Herald of the Abyss, I don't know what the name is. What was it called? I just want to recap. Yeah, Herald of the Abyss. It's a good ultra rare card. So yeah, he got rid of my monster. Now I can just synchro for level 8, which is nice. Or I can go for level 6 either way. So now I'm just abusing the solitaire and making level 2. And then I'm just... I don't know why I did that, to be honest, but I just made level augmentation plays and made level 10. Oh wait, that's why I did it. Okay, never mind. So yeah, it's replay, so it's going a bit fast. So he's going to treacherous my field. I'm like, sure, I'm just going to banish whatever resource in my grave, and I'm just going to abuse the Squire effect. So now he's going to inversing Ritual Beast. So lucky for me, he didn't set the Petal Fin, the Pink Dolphin, and I just OTK'd him because, well, not OTK, I just beat him because he didn't have the he didn't have the Petal Fin, so I can actually get around that. So what was my starting hand? So my starting hand is the Gold Sark, Well Like Clash, Cosmic Cyclone, and level 3. Now this hand's actually pretty bad in terms of stuff, but the Gold Sark actually does save me later on, but it depends, because all I have to do is set pass. Gold Sark's not that good right now. So he goes for the Galaxy Cyclone. Lucky for me, he set another back row, so that treacherous is there, as long gone. So now I can actually make Gold Sark plays. Lucky for me, I drew whatever I drew, if I drew, like, any of the level 4 monsters, I was going to make a synchro no matter what, but since I drew this one, I drew the Shurinuri Solitaire, so either way, I was going to either make a level 7, but since I knew the Gold Sark would make better plays first, I used the Gold Sark first, rather than going synchro plays, because fitting resources much, much better. So yeah, I'm gonna go for more synchro plays, bit of lag there, and go for a Shirino Sun Saga, Squire Saga, sorry. So and then I can just abuse the stuff later on, and now I can abuse a Solitaire, and yeah, make more synchro plays, and that's how you can actually OTK. So resource management, you don't technically need the other Spirit Master, because you're going to make a lot of good plays turn 1 or turn 2, whatever, as well. So yeah, if you want to run free, run free. But yeah, that's up to you. I'm not complaining about you running 1 or 2 of a certain card, just run whatever you want. As I said from the disclaimer video, run as many copies as you want, you don't have to listen to me, you can run 2 cards or 1 card or whatever you want. And yeah, that's pretty much the breakdown of everything. So then I just make a level 10, yada yada, then I set a floodgate and pass turn. That's the best I can do for that turn. So now I'm versing Ritual Beast again. And this is the part where it gets kinda scary. So I have to time it right because of that floodgate, because I don't want to floodgate into a Ritual Monster which it can tag right back. So he's gonna do that, he's gonna he has a Pelfit now, so this person has a Pelfit, so he's gonna banish whatever to send my level 10 home. So now I just floodgate him because that was the perfect moment, since he can't tag out again because he already special summoned all of his other ritual beasts. So now I can just go all in, and yeah, this is how you manage your resources perfectly. And I make a level 8. And this is where the abusement comes in for Shiranui. You can actually do so much in this. So then I go into that, and then he goes ambush. I'm like, okay. So now he's probably going to go for another play. He's going to return the back ritual's hand. He's going to lava golem me. So now he's going to go for other plays. He's probably going to bounce the lava golem to my hand. I knew I was not going to get OTK'd, because Ritual Beasts can't really get OTK'd unless they have a specific card in their hand, which is the spell card. So I thought I was safe, in a way, since I wanted to spam the field. The reason why I summoned all those monsters back was to wall myself. They do run the Lava Golem now, or whatever, to suck my monsters. So yeah, either way, I was going to make Null Sun Saga. But since it's non-targeting removal, I can just pop whatever. And popping the back row was really, really good. Surprisingly, he set the face down, the spell card, which is interesting. But then I proceed to OTK him, because I knew I could OTK him. And yeah, that's it. I think. Let me just see if there's still a replay after this. No, there's not. Okay, so then I go into the deck profile. But yeah, that's my breakdown of this whole video. Wow, I nearly went for an hour just to discuss all this. But yeah, that's my take on the Shirinuri deck. You can run as many copies you want. You don't have to run two Spirit Master like I do. You can run 3 copies if you want. If that's what you want to run, go ahead. I'm just opening stuff up as a open discussion. I'm just saying stuff as an open discussion. Like, if you want to run 2 copies, run 2 copies. If you want to run 3 copies, go ahead. I'm not complaining. I'm not saying no to it. I'm being very honest and open about what you can run, or what you want to run. I'm not saying no that you can't run it. I'm saying you can run as whatever you want. That's all. Hope you guys enjoyed this long discussion video. Sorry for this rant, I just want to get this over with. I'm trying to say that this discussion was based on turn 1 plays. Anything that you say turn 3 onwards, I'm perfectly agreeing with you 100%. Turn 3 plays onwards, Spirit Master is broken. But turn 1 plays or turn 2 plays, Spirit Master is not a good card, depending on what you open with. If you open up a Solitaire or another tuner along with the Spirit Master, that's a great hand in a way, but it's not a one card tuner. One card synchro, it's not a one card synchro. Basically, what one card play playmaking cards is you rely on one card itself, and then nothing else to give it backup resources from your hand or graveyard. If you use it from the deck, that's perfectly fine, because Squire allows you to access your spectral swords from your deck, which is perfectly safe and legal in terms of it being named as a one card synchro. I hope you understand this. Please get this straight through your thick head. I'm sorry if I offended you in any way. If this is all by all means being offensive, I'm very, very sorry. I'm trying to be as agreeable as possible without trying to make this as a hate or rant comment, but I just want to get things perfectly clear between us. No harm intended. I just want to make things perfectly clear as much as possible, as I've been discussing through the whole entire video. Thank you for watching this rant video, and yeah, thank you for watching. See you guys next time. Bye.